Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to your one and only show. That's The Flick with yours truly, the Ugandan movie ambassador. Derrick Fasha is my name. And, you know, you're probably guessing why a different set, you know, pimping is going on. Man, this is the work of my producer. And if I don't say shout outs to him before I kick this show off, I mean, I'll be the wrong one. But shout outs to my producer, Dan Owori. He's the main man behind all this. And Farouk, I'm not forgetting you, the main man behind the cameras. And Dennis, the editor. I had to say these guys. I mean, I have to, because without them, this show is, but it's still the best show, you know. Tonight, we're looking at a movie, Kent and Kent, directed by Jayant Maru, a director who directed something more important. Welcome, Jayant, the main man.
How you doing, boss? Not bad.
How was your day?
Very good. Glad to be here.
Interesting.
On good your invitation.
Yeah, definitely. Good to have you.
Yes.
Today, we're looking at Kent and Kent.
Yes.
You don't have to be slow pronouncing that name.
Yeah, it's like a tongue twister.
That's
what we just try to do.
Is,
you know, we just try to do a marketing thing and make sure nobody tries to say the name properly. So they always try to say it, so they say it like three times, so it sticks in their head.
I just said it once.
That's, yeah.
That makes me the Ugandan movie ambassador. All right, let's talk about this movie. What is the story behind this movie?
Kent and Kate is basically a journey of an eight-year-old boy who is facing a neurological disorder called dyslexia.
Okay.
And dyslexia is basically a disorder, not a disease. It's a learning disorder. In layman's term, it's a wiring gone wrong in your human brain. We have a billion wires in our brain, and one wire can just miss a hit somewhere. People like Albert Einstein, the guy who created electricity, Thomas Edison, they've all been dyslexic individuals, but superly highly successful in life.
Okay.
So this was a journey we tried to bring in our daily life, in our Ugandan setting, to show parents that sometimes when your children are not performing well at school, it's not that they're just dumb, stupid, crazy, or they are bewitched culturally. Some villagers would say that. But it's just bringing out that sort of psychological side of it, and also giving it a twist of a kid, an entertaining film, because it's an adventurous film. It's a film whereby these kids embark on a journey to rescue little baby fish, because they feel that they've been separated from their parents. It's sort of like a real life Nemo situation.
I see you've gotten more deep into the movie, but let us just come back to the introductory part. You know, we have this kid trying to, you know, make it in life. And we've seen some scenes, the same exact scenes, in something more important. Why would you have a short movie out of a feature film? Why?
Well, this is what happened is, when we shot the film and when we got the script at hand, at that point, this was, the script was written by myself. And when we were doing the rehearsals and the workshops before we start shooting, this scene was 7 minutes long. And the dialogue was intense between this couple. And, you know, we were just sitting down across the table and everybody was like, this could actually be a very nice short film. So we released the short film before we released the feature film.
The feature film.
Why aren't you wake Kent up? You don't get it? It doesn't matter to you that you miss Kent's football game. It matters that you don't even give a damn about it. You know, if you had taken 5 minutes off your busy schedule to just consider what your son has been asking for constantly for 3 weeks.
Julie, this is about the football game. Finally, a straight answer. Well, let me tell you something. Kent is not going to understand now. He's going to understand 10 years from now when he cannot go to the college school that he asked for because I was unable to work for 14 hours a day.
Creativity at its best. Let me just rewind you back a little bit to your introduction of what this movie is about. You know, you're telling us about this, the disorder this kid has, and you know. My question is this movie based on a true story?
He purposely repeats his mistakes and his mind is always somewhere else.
And as you must be very well aware that this is Kent's second year in P4. Now, if he continues like this, I'm afraid we shall not be in position to carry on with him.
Yes, it is based on a true story and partly fiction as well. Because it happened, because, you know, as a filmmaker, you're always looking for inspiration around you. And the inspiration for this film came from one small cocktail party that I was attending. And a mother was telling me her ordeal about how her son is dyslexic, and you know, elementary normal school wasn't the place for him, and international schools that offer dyslexic, you know, trainings and sessions were very expensive, for her. So where does a mother like that take her child to?
Mm-hmm.
And then the resort that she told me is that she started homeschooling her son.
Okay.
But on the other hand, it's, you know, dyslexic children are not, it's a learning disorder.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So it just needs an extra 2 to 3 hours a day with that child to make him understand something.
Interesting. So I would relate this movie to something of more educative, you know, when it gets to bringing up a child.
Yeah.
Let us talk about the setting of this movie, the location. Why is this movie shot?
The movie was shot entirely in Kampala in Uganda and spread across various locations from our Gaba Beach resorts to the very famous Kitante Primary School that's said to be one of the pioneer schools in Uganda.
Mm.
And the opening was done by the Queen at the colonial periods.
Okay.
So it was a beautiful set to be on with over 2,500 children.
We're going to get to that just after this question. How long did this movie take you to shoot?
The total period of filming was a month.
A month.
Yeah,
with what
days.
Equipment? With what cameras?
We used a Canon Mark III and we had like two on set and, you know, just elementary lights and stuff because our budget wasn't very big as well.
Let us talk about one of your scenes. My favorite scene in the movie, actually. The Gaba scene when this kid is having a dream and, you know, you are trying to pull the kid out of the water.
Yeah.
These fishermen are trying to, you know, rescue the kid. I'm probably assuming this kid doesn't know how to swim.
Mm-hmm.
And from a long shot we see in the movie, the kid is probably in the middle of the lake. How do you guys pull this off to make sure that the kid doesn't drown?
Yeah, definitely. That is all comes down to the production side. And in terms of the scene, it was basically adding to the narrative of the story. Because as I said, they were taking little baby fish to be rescued and take them back to the lake. And this dream was his visual of, for example, if I am separated, if I am fished out, how would I feel? So when you see the film, you'll feel that sense of entrapment, of being caught, you know? Try to make yourself be a fish. And this is what this dyslexic brain was telling him.
My worry is, how exactly do you pull this scene off? Because we see the kid in water.
Yes. So I was coming back to that. I was coming to that. That, as I said, in the production way. So this is what happens is we put the kid there. He knew how to swim. Of course, we had consent from the parents. And we did tries and errors. But what you don't see is we had 5 professional swimmers underwater.
Underwater.
Yeah, if anything goes wrong. Because as you know, and why we shot in Gaba is because it's a huge landing site
in
Kampala.
That's very
and we have professional swimmers all across that place because they are always in boats in and out and stuff like that. So we basically used the people there, we hired them, and we got the swimmers in there. We told them, guys, 5 people down there, and there were 2 even hiding.
How many takes did you do?
Very surprisingly, because it was, you know, underwater, the guys are there, we can't tell them to hold their breath for an hour and all that. So we made it so planned. We had our storyboard and everything online and we said we're just going to run this thing once and get done with it.
Last but not least, back to the kids at Kitante. Someone may watch this movie and may wonder, did you have to audition all these kids? Or these are kids you just met in school and you just came with a few of your main characters, the young ones, and then you just put them all together?
No, at the initial stage, of course, we had 3 rounds of auditions. I usually audition the first round, then again we break it down from there, and then we audition, and then basically we had auditions. So the children and everybody who has dialogue in the film was selected through the audition process with our casting directors. But the extras,
the ones in class,
those are just extras, you know, you just want them to fill up space and stuff like that, and they're also excited to see a camera in their classroom.
All right. That is very good. You know, time is never on our side, and for that issue I'm just going to ask you one last question. What are you working on right now? What is your new project?
Currently we're working on a project called Sipi. It's a feature film, just like how we have our Sipi Falls, and it is also entirely shot in Kampala, Uganda, and Kapchorwa, where Sipi Falls is. And what I'll just say right now is that it has our Olympic gold medalist Stephen Kiprotich in it.
In the movie?
In the movie.
I need to have him here on the set. I need to ask him some of these questions.
Sooner but later he'll be here.
All right, thank you very much, Jayant, for creating time for the flick.
Thank you.
You've been a hard person to get, but thank you for creating time.
All right, thanks.
All right, that's all I had for you on the flick on Living. And like I said, I have no other way to just wrap this up other than kudos. And I'll see you next time when you see me. I remain yours truly, the Ugandan movie ambassador, Derrick Fasha. I'm out.